Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's discuss how a particular hit series is selected and advanced as a primary lead for a drug program. Upon completion of this video, students will be able to list properties of compounds within a hit series, list selected assays that help evaluate a hit series, and describe some criteria for lead selection. A number of hits will be elaborated in a corresponding hit series. Compounds from each of these hit series will show a range of properties. Well, a typical hit may have an IC50 or EC50 of 1 micromolar. Following preliminary SAR studies, the potency of the series may improve to around 100 nanomolar. The compounds will have confirmed target engagement, appropriate concentration response, and an early understanding of SAR in the series. Hits are initially identified based on their potency in a primary assay, so it should not be too surprising that potency across all hit series is likely uniformly promising. On-target potency will presumably lead to efficacy. There are other properties, however, that must be considered during lead selection. ADME properties such as solubility, membrane permeability, and metabolic stability provide early insight into PK behavior of the compound. Similarly, safety properties can be monitored through inhibition of cytochrome P450 enzymes, inhibition of the hERG channel, and perhaps target selectivity, such as if the target is within a family of targets and selectivity within the family is critical. All the ADME and safety properties here can be measured with in vitro assays, so the drug discovery group can very readily gather this information for various lead series. For example, in a large pharmaceutical company, these types of assays are routinely being performed to support all the various concurrent research programs. With data in hand on the various hit series, the discovery group will need to pick a series to advance as a lead in the discovery program. This is the lead selection step. The best hit series will be selected based on a combination of potency, ADME, and safety results. The activity in these areas need not be ideal. All will likely have room for improvement, and any serious liabilities, such as hERG channel inhibition, will also be noted as priorities to be addressed during lead optimization. Another factor must be considered is whether compounds in the hit series can be patented. The compound must find pockets within chemical space that are not claimed by others so that they can have freedom to operate, or FTO, as they optimize compounds in the series and hopefully discover a clinical candidate or even an eventual drug. In general, only one hit series will be advanced as a lead, but other hit series will be held in reserve as potential backup leads in case the selected lead cannot be adequately optimized. We have listed properties of a hit series, as well as assays that are used to evaluate hit series, from the primary assay in the initial screen to various in vitro ADME and safety assays. Finally, we described some of the criteria used to select a lead from a hit pool. That was a quick review of lead selection and the process of prioritizing one hit series over another. Please consider subscribing, leaving a like, or making a comment. Take care.